Sparrow, can you say that EA is a bunch of con men? Hello, he, she's, and they's, and I'm gonna say he, she's, and they's. Just the fact that I got this comment. No shade, but I literally cannot believe that the one thing that came from that video from this guy is my political views. I'm literally not even bashing him at all. It's just so funny because I'm over here like, I hate EA. EA is bad. Sims 4 is bad. Sims 5 is gonna be bad, probably. And he goes, "You said he, she's, and they's. That's a problem. Don't send me hate, okay?" I just thought it was funny, honestly. But hi guys, I am back. I'm actually in a new place. I'm actually in the process of moving. That's kind of why I've been kind of MIA for the past 2 or 3 weeks. But by the way, if you haven't seen it, I am having a giveaway on my community tab, so do check that out. I'm giving away 3 stuff packs. The winner will be announced on April 10th over on a community tab post as well. So be on the lookout for that. You literally don't have to do anything except comment which pack you want and video and video ideas, because head empty, I have no life behind these eyes. But welcome the hell back. Now I've got a little, it's, I think it's gonna be short, I'm not sure. But a long time ago I did a video on gameplay tips and ideas for The Sims 4 because I was just getting bored as hell, and I still am. I have not played The Sims 4 in quite a little bit. And your girl, she was scrolling through Tumblr. Okay, I'm a Tumblr fiend. And I saw this post and I immediately fell in love. It pretty much said like 20 gameplay ideas or tips for like family players or something of The Sims 4. And so I clicked it and it took me to Melindy.com, and oh, I am a simp for Melindy.com. I usually don't agree with the word simp, okay, but this is an exception, okay? So if you're like me, you struggle with gameplay tips and ideas. Like, I know I made a video a long time ago, like I said, about it. But sooner or later, those tips are gonna run out and you're just gonna be like, well, what the hell do I do now? This website is literally a godsend. So this says, "Hi and welcome. I'm India, longtime simmer since the Sim 1, wife and mama who pretty much runs off of sweet tea." And basically she just does a bunch of tutorials and gameplay tips on here that literally save my game. Like, I'm not overreacting. So when I'm missing a little bit from my game, I like to go to gameplay ideas. And this is the post I saw, 20 gameplay ideas for family players of The Sims 4. Then she has 10 gameplay starter prompts for The Sims 4, and 14 cute and creative date ideas for The Sims 4. So let's go ahead, let's take a look at some of these, because the, okay, if you're a family player, you are literally going to love this. Like, I'm sorry. So pretty much like the first thing of the post is she's explaining how she gets asked all the time from other simmers how she keeps her game fun and alive, and she came up with these 20 ideas which are amazing. So backyard camping, I actually never would have thought this. Okay, so I have outdoor tree and I always like to go camping in Granite Falls. Why did I forget? But I literally never thought of backyard camping. So she says, instead of traveling all the way to Granite Falls, you can just pitch a tent in the backyard and have a little camping adventure right in your Sim's house. You could grab snacks, radio, you could roast marshmallows or hot dogs on a campfire in the backyard. I love this idea. Lemonade sale, I've done that before. I'm not gonna go over all of these, by the way. I'm gonna have the link down below so you can check all of them out, but I just wanted to share this with you guys. But I love the lemonade sale, especially with Icy Spicy Scalpel's lemonade mod. I'm pretty sure that I got this. Yeah, so there's like a mod where you can have a lemonade stand and have your kids serve lemonade, and I just think it's so cute. You do need steady living though. Picnic in the park, Sunday dinner with the grandparents. There are so many ideas here, so please do check it out. I love this post. And then if we go back, she has 10 gameplay starter prompts for The Sims 4. So if you kind of need inspiration for your Sims, like, you make a sim and create a sim and then you're like, I don't know what the hell I'm supposed to do with the sim anymore, this is really good for that. And I really do love this 14 cute and creative date ideas post. Couples massage, love at the festival, bonfire bonding, a night of dancing, so many. I love doing couples yoga with my Sims. Like, I love taking out my couples to the spa and having them get like foot massages and do yoga and stuff like that. I really love it. So that that's pretty much all three, which there's a lot of tips. So just because it's three posts doesn't mean there's not a lot. There's a ton for you to explore. She also has like a story kind of thing going on her website, which I've read a teensy bit of it, and it actually is really good. And I love the screenshots that she has too. And if you're like me, I love using the holiday calendar with seasons. So in this post, she like gives you a bunch of different holiday ideas. I made a video like that, but that was a long time ago. And I was not confident. I literally sounded like I was dying. But as you can see, this freaking website is chock full of gameplay ideas. She also has a lot of Ask Melindy posts where she'll get a question from somebody who follows her blog, like, how do you manage to keep other Sims involved with your main household? Or how do you make your Sim family feel like a real family? I know a lot of us struggle with that, especially because I say it all the time, but The Sims 4 lacks gameplay. So this is, it's just a really good resource for you guys to, I check this website often, probably almost every week when I'm playing The Sims 4, which I haven't in a while, but just looking at this really makes me want to play again, especially like the 5 must-have mods for realistic relationships. You can literally never have enough mods. I love this. How to set up your restaurants so your Sims actually get their food. How many fucking times have I had dine out or had my Sims go out to eat, and I literally never get my food? It's so frustrating. But here's some must-have mods for The Sims 4. 16 mods for better romance and relationships. I just really love this website. It's good. It's an all-rounder website. I know this video was a little bit on the short side, but I mean, there's nothing else to explain except that this website is literally thebomb.com. It really did help me bring my Sims to life. Like, honestly, if okay, the OG's here. If you guys remember Antonia, I am still playing her story. I'm still playing her story because of this website. It gave me so many ideas, and I am bored right now, but that's literally because I went through the whole website and did everything. But it kept me entertained for a very long time. I am still moving, but I am gonna do a little bit of pre-recording just so you guys can have videos while I'm in that process. Don't forget the giveaway. Okay, I will actually link the community post down below for you guys to check out. But that's all for me. I will see you guys in the next time. If you liked it, don't forget to leave a like. And as always, don't forget to subscribe. I love y'all. Bye.